Yes, sir.
Good afternoon and welcome here to Sage Up Football. It is a clash of the Titans in Division One as it is the Garneau Elan taking on the Vanier Cheetahs here from Vanier Field in lovely St. Laurent, Quebec on this Saturday afternoon. I'm Mo Khan here for a kickoff and a few minutes away from Vanier as we get ready for two teams who initially did not go in the right direction. For Vanier losing 44-8 to Andre Gasset, and for Garneau winning over St. Jean 38-35 in a thriller in their openers. And now we get ready for a kickoff between Vanier and Garneau, what should be a very sumptuous game between these two teams and how this is going to play out for them moving forward. For Vanier, they'll be in the alternate grays with gray tops and pants along with red helmets, and for Garneau, they'll be in their white helmets, white uniforms, and green uniforms. As we get ready for a kickoff here, the final proceedings here for both teams, as we'll see what for head coach, Coach Joe Kolzak in game number two, a longtime Vanier coach, now taking the reins of the ship, looking to get his first ever win as a head coach at Vanier. And we'll see how this plays out for both teams in early going here, if maybe the second game juniors will not be as existent as they were in the first game for Vanier. A very young team with a lot of rookies looking to get themselves more immersed into this season. Now we get ready for kickoff here between Vanier and Garneau. Two teams looking to really S themselves in the playoff conversation. A win by Garneau today could send a warning shot to the rest of the league. And for Vanier, looking to get back to 500 before they head into the eye of the storm of the games that they have coming up in the next few weeks as they go on the road for two games away from Vanier. And for Garneau, if they were to win this game today, they would definitely send a loud shot towards the big hitters of this conference that they could be a team to be reckoned with come mid-November during playoff time. A lovely Saturday afternoon, blue skies with a couple of drops of clouds, sun is out, and definitely autumnal-like weather for fall football here in this late stages of the summer months that we have left in the month of September, going towards the end of September for fall season. Vanier, Garneau, now we get ready for the coin toss, and then from there, kickoff between these two teams. The question is, who will come out on top in what is a paramount game for Vanier to try to get themselves back to 500? For Garneau, a win, as we said before, could send a loud shot towards the entire Division I landscape that they could be in that conversation for bowl door towards the end of the season. Here's the coin toss coming up, and then from there, kickoff between Garneau and Vanier. Stay tuned for more Division I action here from Vanier. Vanier set to receive the football. Garneau will kick it off, and we'll get the first voyage on offense for the Vanier Cheetahs, who scored only 8 points last week against Andre Grasset in a humbling loss here in the home opener last Saturday night. A week is a long time in politics, but a week to reconfigure and consider their options here for this Vanier team. So Vanier will get their opening opportunity to get this going forward in this matchup here. Vanier will go left to right. Garneau right to left for this first quarter of action here in this 1 p.m. kickoff. For Coach Joe Kolzak in year one, this won't be an overnight renovation, but the goal of becoming the tallest and shiniest tower in Division I could become big in this game against Garneau. Meanwhile, for the visitors, they're coming off a heart-and-mouth thriller in a week one victory over St. Jean. Could they send a massive warning shot that they will be the team to be reckoned with? An early crucial game that will shape the playoff picture. And now, the last rites for these teams. Vanier set to return the kick here as they have their kick returns back in formation. Jaden Lazar will be the near side along with number 31 and Brian Millien, who's now going off the field as they'll bring in a second kick return instead. It will be Wemby Liba who will bring it in. Now he'll go off instead, and they'll bring in Daniel Labato, the former Greenfield Park Packer, who will have his chance. And set to kick off the ball is Maxence Demers, and he'll kick it off from the far hash mark from the 45-yard line. Kickoff now upon us as Vanier makes a wholesale change with the formation as they are going to look to get themselves established with their offense moving forward. So here we go. Demers set to kick it off. His coverage team about to take their position here. Vanier is ready for anything possible. And now we're underway here. On the opening kickoff of week two of the RSQ season is underway. Demers will go to the far side, and that is returnable. And that's going to be brought up ahead. Towards the far end it comes. And dancing through is Lazar. And he will get himself up to the 31-yard line. And that is where John Skoulakis will begin his second game. Last week, unfortunately, was not the game that he dreamt of. He was 2 of 5 for 9 yards and 1 INT, 3 carries for 21 yards. On his opening drive against Andre Gasset, his second attempt, he threw an INT, and the nightmare began for him that Saturday night, and hopefully it will be a better dream today at quarterback. In the backfield is number 6. And Vanier has a 3-by-2 formation. Skoulakis trying to see what will Garneau declare from this. A 3-by-2 formation, Garneau fans, and a delay of game, and a disjointed start for the Vanier offense looking to assert themselves in this matchup here. So they come up empty in the first play, and they'll move back 5 yards without making a move on offense yet. Skrilakis on the ball now at the 32-yard line. It'll be first and 15 from the 32-yard line. 14:29 left here in this first quarter play. Jazon Bile is the third receiver on the right of the formation. Handoff up the middle, and that will go for a 4, if not 5-yard gain, and a plethora of Garneau players in on the tackle. It'll be second down coming up here for the Cheetahs, as that was carried in by Adam Callender, who they have high hopes for. Callender last week had 8 carries for 18 yards for the Cheetahs. And it'll be second down and 11 yards from the 36.5-yard line. Callender in the backfield, 3-by-2 receiver formation. Rashella is the second receiver to the right of the formation. Here's Skoulakis, and he will hand it off again. Callender going nowhere but a dead end, brought down by the front four of Garneau, led by Nathan Charron, his first tackle of the day. And for Charron, last week had a tackle and a half and 2 TFLs against St. Jean. And now it would be a 3rd and 11 coming up here with 13:40 left in this first quarter of play for the Skoulakis-led offense. Skoulakis came by way of Collège Notre-Dame, just down the road from Vanier. First-year kid. Strong football genes in the family. And now this may be his chance to have his moment of glory on a passing down. A 4-pack to his right. Empty backfield blitz from Garneau. Skoulakis going to the far side. That's cupped to the 40. Up ahead to the 45. And that will be very close to a first down out of bounds. Just shot over the 40-yard line. And Skoulakis gets his first completion up ahead. And caught by Adam Callender, who's going to become the bell cow. And now it's a 4th and 1 and a moment here for Kolzak to decide what he will do if he'll go for it on a 4th down and short from the 45-yard line with 13:12 left in this first quarter play. And now the roll of the dice. Skoulakis is in a pistol formation. Callender in the backfield. And would they go for it or they draw them offside? Skoulakis, quarterback draw up the middle. And he is close enough to a first down, brought down by Charron once again. Both teams pointing at the other direction, a first down going the other way, or first down for Vanier. And it is going to be a first down for the Cheetahs. And an early statement here for the Cheetahs, who got out of a hole and now have a first down with 12:40 left here in this first quarter of play. Ball marked off at the 42.75 line. Make it 47-yard line officially. 4 to the right of Skoulakis. Callender in the backfield once again. ISO to the top is Charles. Handoff, Callender dancing, and he's brought down once again. This time leveled by Eloek Belanger. And it'll be second down coming up in about 9 for the Cheetahs with 12:09 left in this first quarter play. So 2nd and 8 officially from the 49-yard line of the Vanier territory. Skoulakis now has 3 to his left, 2 to the right. Laton Dress is the second receiver. That is the top hitter for this Cheetah offense here from the receiving standpoint. Skoulakis, 3-step drop over the middle. Caught by Laton Dress. And a first down inside the plus territory. And a big tackle coming through by Loic Rancourt. And it'll be a 1st and 10 from the 51-yard line of the Garneau territory. And Skoulakis looking much more composed as he gets his feet wet in year number 1. So they move the starting position as it's advanced, and it's been a different dimension from this Vanny offense compared to last week. Blitz from the near side, handoff, Callender to the left side, and away he goes, 45. Callender down the sideline, 35, 30, 25, one man to beat, and he's out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Callender coming up with a cheetah-like attack down the sidelines. And the cathedral noise here at Vanier ever so loud. And it'll be 1st and goal for the Vanier Cheetahs inside the 10-yard line. And they're running and they're getting no huddle offense. Skoulakis, bar snap, loose ball, recovered in time. And that will end that play for the Cheetahs as Devin Willie got that quickly. And a bit of anxious moments here for both teams here. There's a bit of chaos as that will now bring up 2nd and goal for the Cavaliers in the neck of the woods of scoring points. Looking to have a cracking start here in this opening drive and set the tone and lay down the marker against the Garneau defense. 2nd and goal for the Cheetahs. Now at the 10-yard line, a four-pack to the right of Skoulakis. Looking over the middle. Touchdown, Vanier. Bio in on the catch. And for Skoulakis, the offense, they set the tone. And they have liftoff to their campaign this game, up 6-0 with 10-16 left in this first quarter play from Vanier. A galloping effort, and led by Callender, who opened up the holes of Garneau's defense and got that into the score range. Skoulakis found Bile, and now 6-0 lead pending the extra point coming up here for the Cheetahs in this first quarter play. The hole, the kick, right down St. Croix Street, and Vanier up 7-0 here. Grenny with the extra point, and now it is Garneau to chase this game in the early going with 10-16 left in this first quarter of play. So a great start for the Kolzak offense, and now it is time for the FX Garneau offense to come out here, led by Leopold Damordion, who had a fabulous game last week, over 200 combined yards for pass and rushing last week, and we'll see if he can keep this Vanny defense honest in this early going here with his arms and legs. Grenier will kick it off from the near side hash for the 45-yard line. And set to return the kick is number 5, Jonathan Dupuis, who's wearing the number 5 shirt, along with number 84, Adam Bernier, who's parked off on the far side hash. Grenier, the receiver, will perhaps show his length on his leg kicks over here for the Cheetahs. 10-16 left in this first quarter play, 7-0 for Vanier. A much better effort. Effervescent-like start for the Cheetahs. Returnable, and now it is Dupuis from his own 5. Up ahead to the near side, 25-30, one man to beat, and he gets brought down by the kicker in Grenier, and that is where Damordion will begin his voyage on their opening drive of this game from the 37-yard line of the Garneau end. Damordion last week against St. Jean, 15 to 24 for 141, one touchdown pass, 7 carries for 96 yards and 2 touchdown runs. Damordion has got a backload to work with. La Rochelle to his left. Play action, middle, deflected, almost picked off. The front four coming through, and the telescopic arms, the Niwanu coming up big time on that block ball. It'll be second down and 10 coming up for the Garneau Elan. And you talk about the dreadnoughts on this front four. They have a bunch of heavy hitters that can get to the quarterback. Very young they are. Damordion, second and 10. Play action. Stepping up, rolling to his right, pressure, rolling, looking, waiting, patient. Over the middle, caught in stride. 45, 50, into the Vanny territory they go. First down for La Rochelle. The ingenuity coming up big time on that play. La Rochelle had 2 catches for 31 yards. He carried the ball 16 times for 52 yards and 2 touchdowns. And La Rochelle, the dynamic Swiss Army knife player, gets the first down for the Elan, and they'll have this ball inside the 48-yard line of the Vanier territory. And it'll be first and 10 with 9 minutes left in this first quarter play. Damordion, will he use his legs? Not the biggest quarterback out there, but one of the smartest ones in this league. Handoff, play action, near side. That is too much depth. And intended for William Frenette, incomplete. And Frenette had 3 catches for 30 yards and 1 carry for 1 yard last week for the Elan. It'll be second and 10 coming up here from the 47-yard line of the Vanier territory. So both teams coming up with some explosive plays. Callender with a big run, and La Rochelle with a big catch. And the Yak was on the afterburners with his yards after catch. Second and 10 from the 47. LaFontaine in the backfield. And now, looking to the left, that is caught near side. And Frenette in on the catch and the tackle by Fleuron. His first of the day. It'll be third down coming up here for the Elan offense from the 41 and a quarter yard line with 8:10 left in this quarter play. Third and 4 2x2 receiver formation, two in the backfield for Damordion. Champlain showing blitz on the near side. That's a handoff up the middle, and away they go. Lovely footwork gliding this way through is LaFontaine, and brought down by a gang of Vanier players inside the 25-yard line. And that was a run of blitzing ferocity by the Elan. It'll be first down inside the 25-yard line, a gain of 16-4. LaFontaine and this Elan ground game, and they can definitely gash you with their legs, and they have some big Hillamaya mountains to work with as well. First and 10 for Elan. They're in the score range now for this attack. Handoff, LaFontaine brought down rather quickly this time by the Andoro, who came in the backfield and squashed that from nothing. And now it'll be second and 10 coming up here from the 24-yard line. And the dust of bodies starting to clear up. Clock is rolling, 7 to go. Injured player in the field is Daniel Lobato, who got hurt. Played his minor football with Greenfield Park. And no stop play momentarily here from Vanier. 7 minutes to go in this first quarter play. 7-0 for the Cheetahs. Vanier off to a flyer. And now Garneau trying to come back with their own response. Stay tuned here from Vanier for more action. Welcome back here. Lobato being brought off the field. Mo Khan on the call on this Saturday afternoon. 7-0 for Vanier over Garneau from Saint-Laurent, Quebec on a beautiful Saturday afternoon in the last weeks of summer. And for Damordion, he's trying to get the first points of the day for the visitors from Quebec City. He's got La France, the second receiver, to his left. A 2x2 receiver formation. Two in the backfield once again. They keep with the base look once more. Vanier on the blitz. Going deep, far side corner. And that is incomplete. Intended for Fournette. He twisted, he turned. But the corkscrew ability of him did not come up big with the run catch over there. It'll be third down coming up here. And it'll be from third and 11 from the 24-yard line. So Fournette comes up empty. Champlain makes a change as they're bringing in an extra DB. This time it'll be in is Sean Murphy, the linebacker. So they want to watch out for Fournette. He's now the second receiver to the right of the formation. Base look once more for the visitors. Draw play. It is Tremblay, and he is going to go for a few yards. Tackle inside the 20-yard line by the first line of the Vanier defense. And that will be fourth down coming up here in decision time for the head coach in Pompiron, what he will do. And it looks like they're going to keep the cavalry out there, and it will be Cloutier and Tremblay in at quarterback once more. Gain of 4, 37 coming up here. Now 4th and 7 officially for the Garneau attack. So big play here for the Vanier defense and a bigger play for the Garneau offense. 4th and 7, 5:53 left in this first half. Firing to the far corner, 50-50, push off, touchdown. Garneau pending the penalty call. And it looks like the culprit will be Philippe Rachard, who might be called for a push-off, OPI, as he got himself a little bit of leverage on that play. And we'll see now the official call from the head referee. And it'll be OPI on Garneau. And that will move it back. And for Papillon, the question is, do they have the leg strength to go for the field goal, with this now being 4th and 17? And Tremblay will go off. He'll get his last second conversation from the team here. So far, Vanier showing no intimidation or fear against Garneau. And now they do the wholesale change. So Garneau went from potential 7 points to now empty on that drive. And depending where they will go, if this will be a punt, and it looks like for Tremblay, he's going to go for the punt and try to pin the Vanier team down in their corner of the field. He'll be marked off at the 49-yard line. Set to return the ball is Leba, who's now marked off on the near side, along with Lazar, who's at center field, waiting for the punt from Tremblay. Wind is at a standstill right now as it does pick up going north to south. The snap, the kick, high into the St. Laurent skyline. Returnable center field. It goes off the upright, and now it will end the play right there as Lazar was looking like a baseball center fielder looking to field that ball but had no chance. And Champlain-Vanny, that is, will get the ball coming up from their own 25-yard line. So first and down from the 20-yard line for the Cheetahs. They'll have it marked off on the near side hash. For Giant Skoulakis, a beautiful drive on the opening possession. End up scoring a touchdown. And now can he come up with a second, going for 2 for 2? Last week was a complete nightmare as they went in reverse, but this time this machine, this engine revving like a Ferrari out there. He's got 3 to his left, 2 to the near side right. Blitz from the middle. Skoulakis sees it. Pressure, sacked. Brought down by the second level of defense, led by Zachary Marassette. And in coming in on the party was Loic Rancourt. It'll be second and long coming up for the Cheetahs as they sent the full breach here with 4:57 left in this quarter play. Going off will be Callender as they bring an extra receiver to work with. Dwayne Charles now, the receiver to the near side, right, occupying the width. Latendresse is the second receiver to the right. Skoulakis deep in his shadows of the goalposts. Screen, near side, to the 20 and up ahead to the 23-yard line. Diving for more yards is number 35 in Jaden Lazar as he got the lost yards plus more and becomes much more manageable for the Cheetahs. And a flag in the play and 2 flags in the play. And this might be going against the Vanny Cheetahs. And this is not what Kolzak wanted from his young team as Latendresse will be sent off. And not happy about that at all is the referee. And Kolzak will not be happy with the rush to the blood moment here for Latendresse as he had a blush of a moment that will not be spared. And as a result, they'll be marked off at their own 3-yard line. So what would have been much more manageable now becomes a little bit more deeper as now is 4:19 left here in this first quarter play. Skoulakis 3 yards deep in his end zone. Lazar in the backfield. Handoff stopped. And that is close. And we'll see where they will have it tagged off here. But Lazar barely got out of his end zone. It'll become even more difficult. Fourth down and extremely long for the Cheetahs. And they might have to wave the white flag and try to get as many yards as they can to create more space and a punt come up here. So for the front four for FX, for Garneau, that is looking much more comfortable than before. Willie now the second receiver to the right of Skoulakis. Lazar in the backfield, handoff. Lazar up the middle as he grinds his way for about a few yards. We'll get this to the 5-yard line. And it'll be a punt coming up here for the Cheetahs on a fourth down and an extremely long for the home side. And now Kolzak will make the decision and he will do a hockey shift change and bring in the special teams unit here to get this ball away. And set the return is Frenette, number 3 on the near side. And on the far side is number 8 in La Rochelle. But no matter how you look at it, Garneau will have excellent field position on their next drive with Grenier about 10 yards deep in his end zone. 3:10 left in this first quarter play, 7-0 for Vanier. Grenier will concede the safety, so 7-2 lead. Kolzak playing the field position, then giving up the field position. And now it is going to be Garneau ball going the other way as they get a chance to get back onto the scoreboard with their offense as they were able to get 2 from the Vanny offense. So Desmordions had a big pass over to La Rochelle. And now we'll see how this plays out for him moving forward in this second sequence for him. So the ball is now officially at the 40-yard line. Now marked off at the 35-yard line officially. And they got all fans here in numbers trying to get their team going. 7-2 lead for Vanier over Garneau. 2:55 left here. Ball on the 35-yard line. Damois Dion, 2-by-2 look once again. Play action, looking, pleasant, and that is over the middle. Intended for Fournette. And too much depth on that. In on the coverage was Jolie along with Cucci as they both had the bracket coverage on Fournette. It'll be 2nd and 10 coming up here for Garneau. From the 35-yard line, Champ. This has been a championship-like moment here for Skulak in the opening drive. Second drive was not as great, but now looking to get the ball back late in this first quarter play. Garneau, handoff, left side. And through a dust of bodies of gray, La Rochelle gets about 4 yards or so. Tackled by Neandoro, and it'll be a 3rd down coming up here for Garneau. 2:20 left here, 35 officially. So Neandoro in on the tackle, and now trying to get themselves some more to work with here. 2:10 left in this first quarter play. 2-by-2 look once more for Garneau. Then Mordillon. Blitz from the second level. Rolling to his right. Waiting, looking, sacked. Neandaro in on the sack. And he was brought down rather quickly along with Niawawu. And now it is going to be a 4th down coming up as Vanier will get off the field with no damage done to their defense on that drive. So the Vanier defense looking much more vicious and delicious out there. And now a punt coming up for Garneau. Tremblay will be punting it off from his own 16-yard line. Sent to return it is 2 of them. And Lazar, who's on the near side. On the far end is Liba, who's not far from the Vanier bench. 1:30 left here in this first quarter play. And that is punted center field. Running up is Lazar. To the logo he comes. And he's tackled inside the plus territory at the 53.5-yard line for this next drive for Skoulakis, his best starting position of the day in this first quarter of play. So Lazar returns it back. Skoulakis, 1 touchdown pass. He's been sacked. He's looked at La Tendresse and counter as his 2 safety valves. And we'll see now how this plays out for this 3rd drive. La Tendresse back in the game. He's the 2nd receiver to the left of Skoulakis. Calendar in the backfield, 3 to the near side right. 4th down lineman for Garneau. Skoulakis, a broken play. He's going to take off, and he's brought down by Rancourt, who had the sack earlier in the first quarter. And it appears that Rancourt might be babysitting Skoulakis wherever he goes with his legs. And it'll be 2nd down, intense. No gain on that play. And with about 42 seconds left here in this first quarter play, Vanier trying to add a little bit more gloss to the lead of 5. Bile, the 3rd receiver to the right of Skoulakis. 1-step drop, Bile catching that for a couple yards on that play, and he's brought down rather quickly. Tackled by Sinez, the linebacker, Sean Sinez, who they have very high hopes at Garneau. They think he could be the next big one with this Garneau program, wearing the number 33 shirt for Garneau in this game. Last play this first quarter play will be 36 from the 50-yard line. Skoulakis has got 3 to his left. Callender in the backfield once again. Low snap. Pressure, rolling, taking off, and he will be brought down by a plethora of Garneau defenders, but he got hit and a flag in the play as Charon might be called for hit to the head, and that will give Vanier an extra 1st down. Shatila in also in the tackle, and now the referee's conversing in the congregation of 3 and what the call will be, and now they'll have it done and they'll talk to Vanier what this will be. So it will be a legal hit on Garneau. They will get the 1st down indeed and move it up. But the question is, what will be the conclusion of this play? So it will be advanced. And Hit to the head is the call. First down for Vanier from the 35-yard line. So they have one untimed down left in this first quarter play. Skoulakis took a vicious shot from not one, not two, but three Garneau players. And we'll have one more chance here from the 35-yard line before we head to the other end for the second quarter play. Our four pack is left. Four down linemen for Garneau. They got two linebackers inside the box. Skoulakis, Callender, dancing. Quick footwork by him, gliding along up to the 30-yard line. And now that will end the first quarter. Vanier 7, Garneau 2 as a switch ends. Vanier had a flyover start, and the defense has come up big for them. Garneau chasing this game down by 5. Stay tuned here from Vanier. Welcome back here, quarter number 2. Mo Khan on the call, 7-2 lead for Vanier over Garneau. They are heading right to left for the second quarter of action. Vanier had left off through their campaign with a beautiful touchdown drive by Skoulakis. And Garneau got 2 points on a conceded safety from the Cheetahs. Vanier driving now, and here they go. First play of the second quarter, Skoulakis stepping up in the pocket. And he is sacked. Might have been a face mask. Was not recognized, and he's brought down by Sinez. And it'll be now third down coming up for the Cheetahs. Skoulakis held on to the ball, and he got torched by the front 7 of Garneau. Third down coming up. Clock is rolling. 14:25 left here in this first half of action. 3 to the left, 2 to the far side right. 6 in the box for Garneau. Third and 10 for Skoulakis. Can he make a big throw now? Looking to his left, firing away, picked off. Garneau is off and running and picked off by Eloek Goujon-Bélanger, and a massive stop on the defense by Garneau as they get the first turnover going in their favor. And last week, Bélanger had 5.5 tackles, 1 INT and 1 TFL. Now add number 2 to the INT total for the season through 2 games. And with 14:04 left here, it is now Garneau back on offense, looking to get their, perhaps their first lead if they score a touchdown down by 5. Demardin, the pistol quarterback. 2x2 receiver look. Fournette is the second receiver to the left. Here's a handoff to the middle, and nothing but a wall of gray bringing down the ball carrier for Garneau. And that will go for very minimal gain in this drive. And that was carried by La Rochelle, who's had a bell cow of work for the Elan. It's been a great battle along the line of scrimmage right now. And now could Damardion find a pocket of space to work with to get himself this ball moving forward. Second and 9, 13:24 left in this first half of play. Another handoff. And again, nothing but a couple of grind yards for this Alain running game led by La Rochelle as he was brought down rather quickly by Niawawu. And now it will be third down coming up as they'll bring in an extra receiver. And it will be Thomas Castonguay who will come in for Garneau on this drive. And going off will be number 32 is Medric Lachance. No changes yet for Vanier as it will be 37 from the 35-yard line with 12:50 left in this first half of play. First change in formation will be 3 now to the left of Darmaudion. La Rochelle is in the backfield to his left. Low snap, botched. Looking, rolling, waiting, throwing. Enough for the first down and more. And that is caught by Castonguay. It was a moment of chaos, a moment of brilliance for Garneau. And they get a first down out of it. And they'll move the sticks up to the 53-yard line of the Garneau territory. And that is the first catch for Thomas Castonguay. 18-yard gain from the 53-yard line with 12:19 left here in this first half of play. The Amalgadian works magical and chaos, and that was a chaotic moment for Garneau, and they come up smelling like roses. And he will take off. And he fumbles the football, recovered by Vanier. Poulard in on the recovery, and that was stripped away by Niawu. And Vanier gets the turnover back to even on their first turnover created by their defense. It'll be first and 10 for the Cheetahs from their own 52-yard line. And a mistake by Garneau results in a turnover in favor of Vanier. Could Vanier punish them for points? Shkolak is coming back in at quarterback. Vanier was ruthless on their opening drive, trying to find that tonic once more. Latendresse is the fourth receiver to the right of Skoulakis. In the backfield is Leba. Pressure, he evades it. Skoulakis brought down for a sack. From behind, sacked by Ridolfi, and he is slow to get up. Skoulakis got hit from behind, and his ankle might have been rolled at the 45-yard line. And with 11:28 left here, the point of contention now for the concern for the Vanier Cheetahs is Skoulakis is down after taking a sack from behind. And for Coach Joe Kolzak, he might have to go into the Rolodex of the quarterback options that he has to work with here. Skoulakis being looked at on his left side. By the Vanier training staff. So both defenses have played exceptionally well since the opening touchdown by Vanier. But now for the Cheetahs, their concern is John Skoulakis and what his health is moving forward in this matchup here, as he took a sack from behind and his ankle might have rolled up on him by the sack artist of Garneau in. Martin Johnston, I beg your pardon, on the sack for Garneau. So Skoulakis is down right now. We'll be back here from Vanier. 7-2 lead for the Cheetahs over Garneau. 11:28 left here in this first half of action. And right now for Vanier, they'll have to figure out what the next move is at quarterback, and it appears Jordan El Rimawawi is going to come in now for the Cheetahs. We'll see what he can bring to this arsenal for this Cheetah attack. Skoulak's being helped up. El Rimawi will come in now for the Cheetahs, as he'll get his first action for the Cheetahs. Had no stats last week, and now for Skoulakis, he'll be brought to the Vanier tent as he has to be helped off the field, as he's put a little bit of weight on it, but right now we can't confirm what the situation is, but hopefully it's not too bad for him, as now it is Jordan El Rimawi and his show to carry the load for the time being. 11:28 left here in this first half. El Rimawi will have his first action of the season. Blitz showing by Garneau and a flag in the play, and it appears it is Senez who might be called for offside. And they'll move it up five, and it'll become a little bit more easier. It becomes second and 10 from the original line of scrimmage coming up for the Cheetahs from the 50 and a quarter line. So the storyline now is Skoulakis took a sack from behind, now being looked at. Jordan El Rimawi is the quarterback as he will get his first play. Second and 10 for the Cheetahs. Handoff up the middle and into the plus side of the logo. And a big run coming up this time for the Cheetahs, led by number 23 in Willie, who gets his second carry of the game. Gain is 6. It'll be third down coming up for the Cheetahs with 10:52 left here at the 54.5-yard line. Will Kozak keep it more simple for El Rimawi to get himself further immersed into this game? Another handoff. Willie will go for maybe 1-2 yards at best. And now a fourth down for the Cheetahs. And a question will come up. Will they punt the ball away? They will indeed, and pin Garneau deep in their territory. So Garneau will get off the field. Down by 5 with 10:20 left here in this first half of action from Vanier. And a fourth down for the Cheetahs. And set the return, punt the ball will be Laurent Grenier. And returning it back will be La Rochelle, who's on the near side, along with Frenette on the far side for the Garneau returners. Grenier parked off at his 41-yard line. And he will kick one up into the St. Laurent skyline, returnable on the near side, 25. It is Frenette. He's got space now. Frenette, get us around one, tackle to the 30. And that is where they begin their next campaign here, flag on the far side. And for Garneau, they might be moving back a little bit here. And this might come a little bit longer in terms of the drive yards for Damardion moving forward. So Damardion had a fumble on this last drive, recovered by Vanier, but Vanier could not convert for points. And they lost Skoulakis on that drive as well, on a sack coming up from Johnson. And they'll move it back, and this will be deep inside the group. Garneau territory now at the 15-yard line. So first and 10 for Damardion. He's got La Rochelle in the backfield, 3 to the right, 2 to the backside left. Could they get their RPO going a little bit more efficiently than before? Down by 5. Damardion, handoff. La Rochelle will skid his way through and smuggles himself for about 3, if not 4 yards. Flagging the play once again from the back judge. And this is going to be against Vanny, it appears. And they'll move it up against the Cheetahs. And now a big part of this will be going against Garneau. So this will be against Garneau with 9:45 left in this first half of action. So 10-yard penalty is now second down and long for Garneau. 9:39 left in this first half. 3 to the left. Demardino fired to the right. Through the hands. Incomplete. Intended for Rochard. In on the coverage were two Vanny DBs, led by number 25 and Jonathan Cucci, along with his teammate in Flaron. It'll be third down coming up here from the 15-yard line. Garneau has not been able to find its identity yet in this game here, trying to carve its way through and keep this damage at very minimal right now. Right now, they've not found the candidate to success from one of their pass catchers yet. Frenette is the third receiver to the left of the formation. Handoff to the left. La Rochelle pirouetting his way up ahead over the 23-yard line and still going at the 25-yard line and brought down. This will be fourth down coming up here for Garneau. And decision time for Garneau. And it is going to be a first down officially as they were able to squeeze that through and get themselves a first down here with 8:53 left. And now they're going to go a little bit more of a no-huddle look here and rush this offense through. La Rochelle stopped in the backfield. Brought down right away Niuayu got in on the tackle, and he was joined along by Niandaro as well. It'll be second down and long coming up here for the Garneau offense with 8:25 left here in this first half. Sudo in on the tackle. He had a tackle and a half last week against Grasset, and it still remains 7-2 with 8:15 left here in this first half. Damal Dion has got a 2x2 look. La Rochelle in the backfield along with handoff. La Rochelle, and he is brought down by Niandaro once again. Very minimal gain on that play. And this will bring up a third down with 7:50 left here in this opening half. This ball marked off at the 24 and a quarter line for Garneau. Down by 5, third and 11. This could be a pass down here for Damal Dion. We've not seen much of his arm yet. We've seen a short pass to La Rochelle, and that's about it from the arm of Damal Dion. Looking, fire one, far side, caught twice, and in the coverage, and caught by Bernier, and that will go for about 3, if not 4 yards, short of the first down. It'll be fourth down coming up for Garneau with 7:13 left, and they'll bring in the punt unit once again. So it's come up empty in terms of the roll of the dice for Garneau. And Champlain will get, that'd be a big problem, will get the ball back here. Set to return the ball will be Lazar. Jaden Lazar is now moving back towards the 51, 52 yard line of Garneau. And it will be Tremblay who will punt this ball. And he is parked off at his 15. Lazar now moving back into his own territory. 7:02 left in this first half. And that is a beautiful punt. Hang time is there. Returned from the 40 up to the 50. And stretching and brought down is Lazar. And he will get about 4 or 5 yards on that return. And back in at quarterback is El Rimawi, as he took over for Skoulakis last drive. So El Rimawi, looks like it is his game going the distance here. Skoulakis still being looked at on the trainer's table to the far side left of where we're positioned. So Jordan El Rimawi has Latendresse to his far right. Callender in the backfield, empty backfield. Swing pass near side, and that ball lacked the ingenuity as Bile had to dive for that. It'll be incomplete coming up for Vanier. And it'll be second down coming up for the Cheetahs. So far it's been a defensive intervention in this first half. Both teams have looked solid on defense. Vanier's yet to give up any points yet, only conceding the 2 on offense. Garneau gave up the opening drive touchdown, and that's been it so far in this matchup. El Rimawi, handoff, Callender, brought down and keeps going. And he will grind his way up into the 53-yard line of the Garneau territory. On first contact, Nathan Charron had him, but Callender kept going like a train, and he got tackled officially at the 54-yard line. It'll be third down and 5 coming up here for the Cheetahs. El Rimawi, a pass it down perhaps. He's got a 3x2 look, empty backfield. Pressure, rolling to his left, feeling it. Charron, sack. And he got out of the box and a flag, and this might be intentional grounding as he saw Johnson Charron in on the tackle of El Rimawi, who tried to get the ball away with desperation, but was their receiver in the area in the pocket space where the ball landed. And the Vanny crowd is giving their view that there was a receiver in the area, and the flag will be picked up, and this will be no penalty. But nonetheless, though, it'll be fourth down for Vanier. They will have to punt this ball away, or will they keep the offense out on fourth down? So they'll punt the ball away. And it appears the ball is marked off initially in the wrong spot, now back in the original spot here at the 53 and a half yard line of the Garneau side. Granny will punt this ball away. And Fournette will be marked off on the 20 far side. La Rochelle on the near side. He's now at the 21-yard line. Granny trying to pin this Garneau return team deep. Vanier trying to get to the team talk at halftime and recalibrate. Let's take a one hopper. Fournette will let this roll to the 15. Fournette will pick it up. And Heat will be brought down by Sean Murphy. And for Darmon Dion, he'll have his chance to get back out there with 5:17 left in this first half of play. 7-2 lead for Vanny over Garneau. And a flag also on the field. And that's what we picked up here, and we'll see who this will be against. So this will be called against Vanier. So roughing is the call. Vanier will be called for that, and they will get better field position in Garneau. They were going to be deep in their territory, but now they got a few extra yards and can have a get-out-of-jail card to move this back up by a few more yards. And this will be marked off officially at the 41-yard line. What would have been first and 10 from the 26 ends up being first and 10 from the 41-yard line for Garneau. Garneau won here last season 17-3, looking to extend that streak this year. Damon Dion has three to his right, two to the backside left. La Rochelle has been the bell cow so far for the Garneau offense, now moving towards his left. Damon Dion firing, near side, open man, incomplete. Jeté was the intended target, and he did not get the ball. Mathis Jeté looking for his first catch of the season. It'll be second and 10 from the 41. 5:01 left here in this opening half. Right now, the daylight is at 5 points between Vanier and Garneau here. Right now, we've lacked the aerial power from both teams with the passing game. It might be the ground power that might be the key on who wins this matchup when it's all said and done. Damon Dion, handoff. And that will go for 1, if not 2 yards. Isaac Lafontaine in on the run. He got about a yard on that play. And this will be a third down coming up here for about 4:33 left here in this first half. So Isaac Lafontaine will be marked off from the original line of scrimmage. So no gain on that play. And it'll be third and 10. Another passing situation here. Lafontaine in the backfield. Fournette is the second receiver to the right. 6 in the box for Vanny, make it 7. Hand off to the left. Lafontaine going nowhere. A cul-de-sac of gray. And this will be second down, third, fourth down coming up here for the Garneau offense. And they will bring on the punt team. So Vanny will come off the field once again and look to get something going with 3:57 left in this first half of action, up by 5. Millien will be the returner on the near side, and also on the far end will be Liba, who will be marked off on the far side 30. Liba will be next to the Garneau bench, and it will be Tremblay who will be the returner. Fake. Here comes a chance. Could they get the first down? They will indeed. To the near side, 50. Plus territory into the 47-yard line. A lovely move. Magic La Chance on the fake. And Garneau bamboozled Vanier on that play. And they get a sign of life late in this first half. And they'll have the first down from the 47-yard line of the Vanier territory. And that could be a crucial moment in this game if Garneau does score points with 3:38 left here in this first half of action. And you have to wonder for Vanny's defense if they might fatigue given how much they've been on the field in this game. Damon Dion, handoff, Lafontaine to the 40 and out to the 35. Gliding his way through Isaac Lafontaine with the incision and precision to get that first down for Garneau. And you have to wonder if maybe the momentum arrow pointing towards the team in white and Forest Gray with three to go in this first half. Damodion, early movement, and this will be offside. Jordan Williams will be called for that, and they'll give them 5 free yards and become first and 5 for Garneau. And halftime cannot come any sooner for Vanier. And trying to recalibrate right now, and now in the game will be number 95. Number 99 back in the game, SJ Suda. So three-minute warning called. And now 7-2 lead. Timeout here on the field. Vanier up by 5, but they're clinging on to this lead with Garneau driving late in this first half. Stay tuned here from Vanier. Welcome back here to Vanier. 2:53 left in this first half. 7-2 lead for the Cheetahs over Garneau. Le Elan is driving. They had a fake punt that worked in their favor. And now they have a first and 5 from the 30-yard line. And they are hunting for points. Their tails are up right now in this drive. And in at quarterback is Zachary Tremblay. And we'll see what he can bring with his ingenuity. Could the telepathy be created with him and the star receiver in Jonathan Dupuis, who's now the second receiver to the right. 2 in the backfield, two to the far side left. Cloutier handoff. LaFontaine, a beautiful zigzag and a flag in the play. And this might be a holding call against Garneau, which will give a respite to the Vanier defense to move them back by 10 yards. And this will become first and 15 for the Garneau offense, and they'll move it back by 10. And they'll move back to the 40-yard line officially. It'll be first and 15 for Garneau with 2:45 left in this first half. Clucci in at quarterback. They've gone with the quarterback rotation. Fournette is the second receiver to the left. Here's another handoff. LaFontaine to the right. He gets around the first wave and brought down by Niandoro. And it'll be second down from the original line of scrimmage at the 35-yard line for Garneau. 2:39 left here in this first half. If Vanier could come up and hold serve and not give up any points here, this could be a massive confidence booster for them going to the team talk at halftime. But right now, the language and style of Garneau has tired this Vanier front seven down. Could they cash in now on this mistake? Quarterback draw. Cloutier brought down by Mutombo and his teammates in the front four. And this will be a fourth down coming up for now officially a third down, I beg your pardon, from the 31-yard line. 2:09 left in this first half. Clock is rolling, 3rd and 6 from the 31-yard line. Cloutier. Handoff. La Rochelle going nowhere. Suda in on the tackle, and that might have gone for 1 yard at best. It'll be fourth down coming up with 1:52 left here in this quarter play. And this will be now at the 33-yard line, and it appears they'll bring in the field goal unit, and Maxence Demers will have a chance to get 3 more points. Demers taking his first field goal attempt of the season, of this game, that is, and he'll mark it off at the 40-yard line. Wind is very calm, and Champlain will have Leba, who will be inside his territory, marked off on the left of the upright. And Kozak wants a timeout, and he will get a timeout. Not happy with how the look was and the rotational formation that they had coming out here from the subs lined up. And with 1:52 left, it appears that the kicker and Demers will be frozen for a few more seconds and have some time to think about what could be the situation now for the Garneau team. So Garneau, the storyline so far is Skoulakis is out right now. Garneau had a fake punt that has now resulted in them giving themselves potentially three more points to chip away at this lead of five for Vanier. And you have to wonder for this Vanier offense if Skoulakis could make a run in the second half here if he's able to go. If not, it will be on the arms of Jordan El Rimawi to give them a chance to win this game going towards the second half. Kozak with some last second instructions. Paul Brion doing the same thing for the Garneau team as they now will get things going forward here in this situation for Garneau, down by five with 1:52 left in this opening half of action. Fourth down and eight. And it appears that the Mares will go off and they'll bring back on the first team offense here. And Vanny may not have the correct formation out there, and it appears they don't, because it is Tremblay in, and now they have to hope and pray that this does not end up being disastrous. Going over the middle, incomplete, intended for Frenette. And Garneau did not catch Vanny flat foot on that play because the formation personnel was not the correct one, and Vanny holds serve, and they will get the ball back with 1:49 left in this opening half. 7-2 lead remains for the Cheetahs. El Rimawi will come back in at quarterback. El Rimawi so far looking for his first completion. He got sacked. He's got Callen in the backfield. He's got three to his right. He's got two to the near side left. Looking for the last second roll. Swing pass right. That is caught to the 30. Up to the 35, 40. First down and more. Out of bounds is Bile, as Jazon Bile was able to turn a small catch into a first down and a confidence booster for El Rimawi to give Vanny their first down from the 49-yard line with 1:41 left in this first half. First and 10 for the Cheetahs. Flexing over to the left is Malik Savanet, who's now the second receiver to the left. Handoff calendar. Trying to find a hole to go through, and he sees nothing but white, led by Loic Rancor, who's been a complete chief destroyer of the game for Garneau with his ability as a tackler and as a pass rusher. And this will be second and 8 coming up for the Vanny offense to go with no huddle look once again. El Rimawi. Swing pass left. That is caught. Jazon near side. Into the plus territory. 40, 35, out of bounds. Forced out by number 47 and Goujon Belanger. Bile coming up with a big catch. Jazon Bile has been the catalyst on this offense here. He's been the central figure on this drive. And just like that, Vanny is in the score zone from the 30-yard line, needing perhaps another 15 more yards to get themselves in field goal range with 1:22 left into this first half of play. Bile now the third receiver to the right. El Rimawi's got Latendresse to his immediate left, rolling to him over. Handoff, calendar, push forward in to the 25-yard line. And this will be a second down coming up here for the Cheetahs from the 25-yard line. 1:17 left. Be a second and 5. In the backfield now is Devin Willie. El Rimawi, hitch, caught, far side. And that is brought down Grenier by a couple of Garneau players, and this will be close to a first down, and this will be a first down from the referee's mark, and it'll be first and 10 for the Cheetahs with 1:01 left in this first half. 7-2 lead for the home side over Garneau. Ball now at the 20-yard line. And going nowhere is Willie. And this will be second down coming up here for the Cheetahs with 53.8 left in this first half of play. Second and 10 once more. So no gain in that play. Clock is rolling, 52 seconds and counting. Alarima, we would love to go into the half with some points. Looking towards his left, swing pass, counter, low catch, and a loss of yards. And he was brought down once again by Loic Rancourt, who's had a fabulous game. They've had no answer for the man in number 21, and he's been providing the centurion-like approach in this game with some of his tackling. And now it will be third and extremely long of 16 with 36 seconds left, ball on the 26-yard line. Blitz from the near side, from the far side, screen, and counter got blown up, and he got hit by number 33 in Sean Sinez, and he's slow to get it up. Callender did not see that as he looked up in the air for the ball. And now, Vanny, the concern is that they might be down Callender in this first half. And the Vanny crowd giving a pantomime reaction on that play as they thought it was a legal hit coming from Sinez. And Callender did not see that at all. And now he's up, which is the good news for Vanier. So Vanier will look to get the ball in scoring range here, and they will indeed, and this will be a chance here for Grenier to, who needed the kicking tee there. So Grenier will have the ball marked off from the kicking tee at around the 39-yard line from the left hash mark. The wind is going left to right on your screen. So this will require a little bit of geometry and making sure he gets the right weight on the foot-to-ball connection. It's up right down St. Croix Street, and three more points for Vanier. 10-2 lead with 20.6 left here in this first half. Vanier up by eight. They come away with three on a granny field goal, and now for Garneau, they go into the final 20 seconds down by eight, and one last roll of the dice here to perhaps get themselves points before halftime hits. Damal Daniel will come back at that quarterback. The ball will be marked off at the 35-yard line. And in the game, last second coming in is Brian Millier as they bring on an extra DB for this situation now as they're preparing for the passing attack for Garneau. Damal Dion. Play action. Screen pass left. And going nowhere. Millier in on the tackle as he devoured Bernier for maybe a yard at best, if not no gain. And now it is going to be a timeout called. On the field, as Garneau makes a couple of changes, as going off is La Rochelle along with number 32 in La Chance. And with this being a second and nine with 13.1 left here, not much in the playbook of menu options trying to get themselves more points. So Vanny calling a timeout. Garneau trying to unlock this Vanny defense. They've yet to score any points with their offense so far in this first half. They scored 38 last week against St. Jean, and this week, nothing yet. Lacking the cutting edge so far is the Garneau offense. Damal Dion might have to go into his bag of tricks to give Garneau a chance. Three to his right. Going deep left. Post play. Incomplete. Intended for La France. And in on the coverage was number 20 for Vanier and Anthony DiCaprio. If you know that name, it's a very familiar name in the halls of Vanier. And with that, it's a 3rd and 10 coming up here, 7.2 left in this first half. 3rd and 10, 7.2 left, ball on the 35-yard line. Damar Daniels got 3 to his far left, 2 to the near side right. One step drop, looking, waiting, pressure at flush, sacked. Brought down by the front four of Vanier. 2 seconds left on the clock. And that was, you pick your number, and it looks like Sudo was the one who got the sack on that play. And this has been a ferocious attacking line from Vanier, rather young in youth, in age. But it's been serene, it's been quality, it's been composure, and they have this lead of 8 going towards the halftime. So the last play of this first half, Damar Dion will try to carve something out on this last play. Handoff up the middle, and that's a fumble recovered by Garneau. And at the end of the first half, Vanier 10, Garneau 2. Stay tuned, we're through 30 with 30 to go. Vanier, could he get their first win? For Coach Kolzak, will Garneau pull off the smash and grab in the second half? Stay tuned here from Vanier. We'll be back.
Thank you, gentlemen. We're going to take a Saint-Cien, the Chicas de Bagne. Ladies and gentlemen, former Bagne Chicas.
Off in his player. That's why the thing went off.
I don't know. I haven't heard anything about those two. But, and they had Elwha.
Yeah. Elwha, I know. Yeah.
Elwha, I've never seen him. He'd make first downs like he beat four guys along the sideline and just tiptoe and just pull the ball over for a first down. Unreal.
Yeah, that team, the 2010 batting team, was really good with Jeremy Rock and Norzel and those guys.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that team, too. J-Rock. And then J-Rock gets hurt in the semifinal.
Yeah.
And then they bring in Benoit Lacasse. Yeah. He sunk out of school third. He left school, four touchdown passes in the bowl game.
Down right now, 27.
Yeah. I hate Toronto. I'm not a big Chad Kelly fan. Never liked him. Well, that I don't like. I'm pronouncing his name right. 20-7. You don't change play callers?
I'm so used to having the headset, right?
Oh, yeah.
So I get so sidetracked by the noise.
Oh, yeah.
That was, you know, so.
This is old school.
It's all good. No stress. You got to start somewhere, right?
Oh, yeah. So.
Sorry.
Welcome back here to Vanier at halftime. Vanier 10, Garneau 2 after the first half. And it was a game that had a blistering start to it, with John Skoulakis opening up his account with the opening game touchdown. However, he went down late in the first half with a lower body injury. We'll see if he will come back on out there. And meanwhile, for the Garneau offense, they've been lacking the cutting edge, the ingenuity, have not had the ruthlessness that has been required from them as we get ready for the second half of this game here. 30 down, 30 to go in this matchup. Could Vanny get win number one for Coach Joe Kolzak, or will Garneau ruin the party and have Vanny looking at 0-2 starts? And return up ahead to the near side is Jonathan Dupuis, and they will start the party in the second half from the 35-yard line. And in the first half for quarterback Leopold Damardian, not much going on from him. Had a fumble loss that was recovered by Vanier. Vanier's front four had a marvelous game. They were problematic. They were a thorn. They were a menace. You name it. They were that plus more. And we'll see now how this plays out if the high pedigree of the Vanier front four continues to have the excellent start in the first half going towards the second half. And now the first play of the second half. To the left side it goes. Spin move to the 40-42. And a good start as Charles Gamache is in at quarterback. Gamache in at quarterback and the run by LaFontaine, who has had the bulk of the carries since midway through the second quarter. Charles Gamache now looking to give a bit of a rev to the engine right now that's been in cold. It's been parked for this Garneau offense. Three to the right, two to the near side left. Isolated to the near side with is number 84 in Adam Bernier. Gamache looking towards the left, going deep left near side. 50-50 ball. Incomplete. In on the coverage was Millier. And this will be a third and one coming up here as they had the luxury of the short yardage situation here and now a chance to get the first down through the run. They went for the deep ball, and unfortunately for Bernier, did not come up with the catch. Third and one, 13:46 left here in this third quarter plague. Again, Bernier occupying the width on the near side left. Flexing out is number 10 in Samuel LaFrance. Handoff. LaFontaine stopped, and his teammates coming in on the deluge of gray, adding a little bit of assistance on the layover. And this will be a fourth down, and this went for minimal gain. And the big boys will come out for Garneau as number 59. And Victor Dessy comes in as Gamache goes off. And they'll bring in the big hitters. And including that is Zachary Tremblay as they will go eyeball to eyeball on a fourth and one from the 44-yard line. Who could hold their serve in this situation now on the line of scrimmage? Clock is rolling. South of 13 left in this third quarter of play. In at quarterback is Zachary Tremblay. They're in a wing formation now. A bit of confusion now. And this looked like it was disjointed. And a timeout called by Garneau. And a timeout that they did not want to afford to use early in the second half. That had to be used because of the confusion where the GPS of the formation was in this situation right now. So Garneau calls a timeout here, a bit of a stoppage now for the game here in this opening part of this second half. Right now the daylight is of 8 points. Vanny's up, they had a late field goal in this set first half here. They were fluent and flowing in the first half on the Sulakis opening drive touchdown, and they found some fluency on their last drive with their backup quarterback coming in Jordan Elrimawi, who came in and had a couple of swing passes that found daylight. Jazon Bile was able to create yards after catch on those swing passes that got them the field goal range, and they're up by eight. In fact, Vanier scored all the points. They've scored even the 2 points for Garneau. So Garneau, who scored 38 last week, have been held to a donut this week from their offense. And now on a fourth and one from the 44-yard line, trying to find some daylight here as they look to get themselves a first down to prolong this drive. It is going to be Tremblay in at quarterback under center. Wing formation again for Garneau. Hand off to the left. LaFontaine's got the first and more. And he's brought down by DiCaprio. And a sigh of relief for the Garneau fans as they will prolong this right now. And LaFontaine's become a central figure with his cool finish on that play. So far, Vanier's had some first-class defending. The centurion out there has been the front four. Those centurions have controlled the line of scrimmage. And it'll be first and 10 from the 48 for Gamache and for this Garneau offense. Three to his right. Early movement. And Vanier holds their water. Here's a handoff, LaFontaine. Stop at the second level. Brought down for a loss of one, if not two. And he was brought down by number 89 in Niawau. And it'll be a second and long coming up for Garneau with 11:50 left here in this first half, in this third quarter of play. Ball now at the 46-yard line. Second and 12 to be exact. Philippe Rachel occupying the width on the far right. Fournette is the second receiver to that side of the field. Gamache blitz from the far side, looking to the left, firing too much spice on that pass, intended for Adam Bernier. And in the coverage is number 31, Emilien, who's had a very active day so far. Not much has gone by the way success for Garneau towards Emilien's side. And it'll be a 3rd and 12 with 11:25 left here in this third quarter play. LaFontaine in the backfield. Gamache in a pistol formation. He's got La Rochelle to his immediate left. Passing play. Crosser caught by La Rochelle at the 52, and he will dive close enough to a first down, brought down at the 53.5 yard line. And now decision time here for Paul Briand and his staff, and they'll bring on the bigs out for this chance here, as also coming out there is Zachary Tremblay as well, as they will go for it again on fourth down. They went for it earlier in this drive and converted. They know points are at a premium right now. The currency has been rich so far for their liking, and they have not been able to convert yet for points. Fourth and one for Garneau. Cloutier under center. Hand off to the right, and LaFontaine stopped. Turnover by Vanier, brought down by Suda, who's been a run-stopping force for Vanier. And because of that, Vanier gets great field position going the other way. It appeared momentum was in Garneau's side, but they couldn't get that going through. And still at quarterback is Jordan El-Rimawi, who found his composure, looked like a cucumber out there on the last drive, and now he's got three to his far right. An overload with Rochelle along with Bile on the right. El-Rimawi, jet sweep, near side. And well read, the edge was set and was brought down by Goujon Belanger, who gets a loss in that play of maybe one, if not two. It'll be second and long coming up here for Vanier with 9:45 left here. And going off the field will be Leba, and they'll keep counting in the backfield. Second and 12 from the 53. 9:32 left here in this third quarter of play. Three to the far right. Six in the box for Garneau. Empty backfield. Going deep near side. He's got a man open. Latondres. And that ball had too much depth on that pass, as Latondres had his man beat. And the Garneau defense was Taurus on that play, watching that ball go by them. It'll be 3rd and 12 coming up here for Vanier. Garneau's defense has played exceptionally well so far today. You talk about number 21 and Loic Rancourt. He's had a fabulous game for the visitors from Quebec City. 3rd and 12 for the 53. El-Rimawi looking for the crosser, can't find it. Rolling to his right. Pressure, throwing, caught out of bounds. And that was caught by Dwayne Charles, his first catch of the day. Brought down at the 48-yard line officially. And Charles getting his first catch of the season. Open up his account. And it'll be a fourth down in about four. And Vanier will keep its offense on the field with 8:43 left. Can they return the serve here? They have a four-pack to the left of El-Rimawi. Calendar in the backfield. Passing play. Fired, caught, Charles, first down, tackled by Shatila, and Vanier will keep the drive going with 8:25 left here in this third quarter play. Ball now at the 40-yard line. And they'll keep with a no-huddle, keeping Garneau on their heels, trying to attack their pressure points. Early movement again. They will not hold serve on that. It'll be offside on Garneau. Garneau looking towards the referee, trying to plead their case. Vanier trying to help the case by saying it was offside on Garneau. And this will be against Garneau. So they'll get 5 free yards, become 1st and 5 from the 35 with 8:09 left here in this third quarter play. Now occupying the width on the far left is Malik Savinette. Three to the left. Bile has been the hot hand for El Rimawi. And here he is, swing pass left. And he got botched by his own teammate on the block from Rochella as they're cleaning up the miss with Sinez, who read it, diagnosed it, and tackled Bile on that play. And it'll be a second down and five for the Cheetahs. 7:43 left here in this third quarter play. Callender in the backfield. El Rimawi's got three to his right. Looking towards his left. Firing in a pass. And that ball is sent towards Kodvaktu. And that will go out of bounds with a third and five coming up here with a 10-2 lead. 7:27 left in this third quarter play. And this will stop clock. Still on the 36-yard line. Drive stalling a little bit here. They've not been able to move it. On a third down, the money play for Vanier. El Rimawi going deep center field, man open, incomplete. And the trajectory of the ball kept on going higher and higher and did not find Bile in on that play. And the depth was not there. Daylight was there for Bile, but now they'll bring on the units and they will figure it out now. Lathan just trying to figure out what the call is going to be. He looks like he's going to be coming off the field himself, and they are going to bring on the punting unit now. So what looked like a fizzing start ends up being a punt for Vanier for the second half here. 7:14 left in this third quarter play. La Rochelle is parked on the near side along with Finette, who is now about 10 yards deep in his end zone. And that is sky high, far side, one hopper. Fournette lost in the sun, takes a hop for Garneau, moving back, and a no yards call will be applied. And this will give extra yards to Garneau. And hard to the ground was La Rochelle, brought down by the coverage team of Vanier with 6:51 left in this quarter of play. So yards added, this will be marked off now at the 24-yard line of Garneau. 6:51 left here in this third quarter play. Vanier up by a score 10-2 from Vanier College on this lovely Saturday afternoon here from St. Laurent. Shaw Gamache in at quarterback. They've used all three QBs today. Empty backfield, looking towards the right. And that is going towards the Garneau bench, 10-4. La Rochelle, that'll be second and 10 coming up here from the 24-yard line, 6:35 left in this quarter of play. And again, they've not been able to find the right tonic here. The Garneau offense here, lacking the wizardry in this third quarter of play. And now trying to get something going here. Can hit the ground running in this third quarter play. Blitz from the near side from Vanier. Hand off to the middle. And that is going to go for maybe 1 or 2 yards. The run defense for Vanier has been problematic for the line of scrimmage of Garneau. And that is a run of very little gain here. And slow to get up is one of the Vanier players. And that could be a big concern now for Vanier, as your defense has played so well with the rotations, and it appears it is going to be perhaps a cramp. As it is not a warm day, but of course hydration is a must. And we'll see which play that is from Vanier, as they like to get that cramp loosened up here with 5:59 left in this third quarter play. Vanier up by a score 10-2. Mo Khan on the call on this Saturday afternoon. Garneau have yet to score points in this game. The storyline has been the lack of efficiency from both offenses in this game here. It appeared that we were looking like we're going to have a high scoring game when Vanny opened up the game with the first touchdown. And since then, we've been looking for touchdowns. It's been high and low of the GPS not finding the end zone for either side. And for both teams, it's been a defensive stalemate in how this has played off in this game. So the meaning of these two reps with intrigue, a win by Vanny would be massive. A win by Garneau would be huge because that would send a warning shot towards the Division I ranks that they could be in play. And that could be a severe injury right there of cramps, perhaps. Hopefully that is the case. Savannah down at man in terms of the depth to work with. It's now 3rd and 10 for the Garneau offense. Gamache looking to get this going forward in this situation. 3 to his left, 2 to the backside right. 4 down line for Vanity, got 7 in the box overall. Gamache. Empty backfield, early movement, and it'll be 5 free yards. As Jonas Marr was caught going a little bit earlier than expected. And it'll become 3rd and 5 for the Garneau offense. Third and five for Garneau. What do they have in their bag of tricks here from Quebec City? Could they use the dark arts of football to create something in this situation here? 3 to the left, 2 to the far right. Gamache trying to find something of glory. Looking towards the right. Incomplete, intended for Bernier. And in on the coverage was number 44 in Cisdolo, and this will be a punt coming up here on a 4th and 5 for Garneau, who will play the field game position here as Lazar will make his way into this game. He's parked off at the 40-yard line, and it will be Tremblay who will punt it off as he's marked off at his own 19. Now moving back towards the 18, make it the 17.5-yard line. Vanier playing the safe route. They got bamboozled on the fake punt by Garneau in the first half. Don't want that to happen again in the second half. Garneau would love to create something out of this. Tremblay. High snap. And we'll get it off. Ice cool veins by him. Returnable by Lazar. Far side 50. Up ahead to the plus territory. And he's inside the Garneau end. So El Rimowai will have a great start of field position to work with on this sequence coming up here for Vanier. And Vanier looking to get this going in the right direction here, up by a score of 10-2. Could he add a little bit of gloss of their lead of 8 and make it a 2-score game? It appears first team to 15 might win this game at this point of this matchup. El Rimowai. Here's a handoff, up the gut, and a big tackle by Senez as he rocked the ball carrier for Vanier. And that will be a second down coming up here as Lazar did not see that come as clean as he wanted to, and he got hit. And this will be a 2nd and 11 here for the Cheetahs. Labatt occupying the width on the near right. Looking for the screen pass. Can't find it. And El Rimowai will have to throw it away. He was waiting. Lazar could not get open as Garneau dissected that play before it happened. And now it's a 3rd and 11 from the 53 with 4:16 left here in this quarter. Kolzak trying to find some sort of potion. Right now they lack the ingenuity. Looking to create something in the second half. Dwayne Charles now occupying the width on the far left. Labatt is on the near side right. Rolling to his right is El Rimowai. Firing away, open. Enough for a first down. Bile tackled at the 38-yard line. Brought down by Demers. And you've seen so far when they move El Rimowai out of the pocket, he's been much more effective, and he was able to torch Garneau on that play. And now a first down for the Cheetahs from the 38-yard line with 3:37 left here. El Rimowai's got 3 to his left, 2 to the near side right. Looking towards right. To the sidelines it goes. Caught by Latendresse, and he's brought down by Boiteau Paré. And it'll be 2nd down coming up here for the Cheetahs. 3:18 left in this third quarter play. Gain of 4 yards on that play. Ball now at the 33-yard line. Bile is a third receiver to the left. He's been the hot hand. He has a telepathy with El Rimowa. Garneau showing blitz from the edges. Will he send it again with Rancourt coming in? And they do. Botch snap, loose ball, light ball, recovered by Garneau. Garneau comes up with their second turnover. Nathan Charron in on that. And the snap execution was lacking. And Garneau was able to find it. And now they get the ball back. You're 2:56 left in this third quarter of play. Garneau stand their ground, and now they get the ball back here. Can they create something here? Could that be a crucial moment in this game here as Vanier was hunting for some insurance points in this third quarter? And now this remains in the balance with plenty of twitch and jeopardy to go with. Gamache has an overload to his right. Blitz from the near side. Gamache looking, firing deep. Fournette flagging the play. Coverage in by number 25 in Cucci, and he will be called, it appears, for either PI or illegal contact, as Fournette was able to torque his body and create something out of nothing. But Garneau will get a fresh set of downs, and this will go against Vanier. So a first down for Garneau, 2:32 left, now at the 51-yard line. So gain of 15s, and Vanier on their heels a little bit. A fumble loss, and now a gain of 15 on the penalty, and the Garneau partisans are starting to voice their excitement. Again, an overload to the left of the formation for Garneau. Vanier showing blitz on the near side, and early movement once more, and this will be against the visitors from the nation's capital. And this will be marked off now at the 46-yard line. Garneau from the provincial capital trying to get themselves a chance to capitalize on that mistake from Vanney's fumble. 10-2 lead, 2:05 left in this third quarter of play. Gamache fired near side, that's caught. And out of bounds is Dupuis, forced out by DiCaprio. And that regains the lost yards plus more. It'll be third down, second down coming up for Garneau. Gain of 8 will be 2nd and 7 from the 54-yard line. 1:55 left in this quarter play. Gamache has got 3, now make it 4 to the left. Now to the right, that is, as they flex over to the left. Handoff, middle. La Rochelle will get maybe 1 or 2. And in on the tackle with Suda, who's been a phenomenal run stopper for this Vanier front four. And this will be a third down coming up here for the Elan. Could the Cheetahs keep their nerve right now? Could they get off the field here on a 3rd and 6 and force a punt? Trips right. Gamache looking for the completion. Got it! And that will be enough for a first down. Dupuis, second catch on this drive. DiCaprio in on the tackle. And the ball we marked off at the 49-yard line. And now you're starting to see this Garneau offense fizz a little bit here. And Vanier trying to contain the fizz in the bottle on this drive as they'll get a first down here with 38 seconds left in this third quarter of play. They are marching now down by a score of 8. Gamache. Here's the handoff. And La Rochelle got around Suda initially on the first contact and might have gotten maybe 1 yard at best on the second try. Suda being helped off by Dupree. And this will be a second down and nine coming up here from the 49.5-yard line. And this will be the last play of the third quarter. Gamache has been the quarterback since the start of the second half here. Occupying the width in the near left is Adam Bernier. Another handoff to the right side. And La Rochelle was eaten up alive by Naiwuwu. It was a gray minefield, and he got blown up. And that is the end of the third quarter. Now, Naiwuwu in on the tackle, and that will be that. And there's an injured Garneau player on the field. And at the end of three, there's cramps popping up for both teams. And that will end the third quarter. Stay tuned here for the fourth quarter. Vanier 10, Garneau 2. Could Vanier hold on for their first win under Coach Joe Kolzak? Or will Garneau ruin the party with a smash and grab? 15 to go from Vanier College. Stay tuned. Welcome back here to Vanier. 10-2 lead for the Cheetahs over the Elan of Garneau, and it's a 14:55 left here in this fourth quarter of play. Clock is rolling, and the racetracks have to run short for Garneau and try and tie this game up in this fourth period of play as we start off the first play of this quarter. Gamache firing, open, near side, and a drop for Adam Bernier, and his blushes will not be spared as he was wide open for six. And for Vanier, broken down communication, and that will force a punt as they thank the football gods on that play being of no gain. In this game of chess, they were almost caught watching that ball. And that was something that will not be enjoyed by Garneau's offense, knowing they had a chest down on their fingertips. And that ball's kicked up in the air. And that will go out of bounds with 14:28 left. So Vanier comes back out there looking to get themselves some more points to work with. And we'll see what they can do now in this sequence coming up here. El Rimawi has come in since midway through the second quarter to be the quarterback right now. Right now, the end product has been lacking for both teams for touchdowns. Here's a handoff to the right side, and that is going to go for very minimal. Devin Willie might have been lost for a couple yards on that play, and that would be a loss of about two with 14 left in this ballgame. And both front fours have been ferocious in this game here. They've been hungry. They've been oozing with intent, and they've been oozing with confidence out there. And it might come down to that extra yard or two that can win it for either side. El Rimawi's got Willie in the backfield once more. Three to his right. Looking towards his left. Firing deep ball. And incomplete. Dwayne Charles went up like Cirque du Soleil, but cannot come down with the reception. And with 13:31 left here, it remains 10-2 with a 3rd-and-12 for the Cheetahs. And it will be Labatt who will be occupying the width on the right side of the formation. El Rimawi trying to catch Garneau on their heels? Can he find the right pressure point to work with? Lautaro drifts on the motion, rolling to his right. And he'll throw one out of bounds and nearly went out of the football field. And that will force a punt coming up for Vanier on a 4th and 12 with 13-11 left here in this fourth quarter play. So Vanier will come up empty, and now Garneau will have a chance to get back in this ball game. On a nice edge right now, this game here, and no one's found the jackpot yet. Only once we've seen the 7 points by Vanier, but since then it's been all search and rescue of points. And this, with 13-10 left in this ball game, could be a crucial drive for Garneau. La Rochelle and Frenette are both at their 40. A low drive kick. Frenette lets it take the two hopper. Right to the 45 he comes. And he bounces off La Rochelle, going to the near side. Gets around DiCaprio out of bounds. And he will go right towards the first row. And this is where Garneau will begin their next drive. And for Gamache, trying to find some sort of route one option here. The element of caution has now been abandoned by Garneau. Can they find a showstopper moment here? The central figure of this offense has been LaFontaine and La Rochelle from the backfield, but their receivers need to come up with a big moment of glory here. Can they do so now? Gamache, handoff. La Rochelle dances into nothing but a great dust of the front four and brought down rather quickly by Niadoro and his teammates. 12:20 left here. Clock is ticking. Gamache is going to overload a four-pack to his left. Bernie occupying the width on the near right. Can he come up with a big play? Watched by Millien. Motion towards the right. And now a handoff towards the middle. And that will go for about 5-6 yards. Suda in on the tackle. LaFontaine, if he wasn't hooked by Suda, might have been going for another 15 to 20. Suda has been an excellent run stopper, playing the interior of the line right now with 11:34 left in this quarter of play. Two by two receiver formation, going back to the base look. Gamache trying to find a first down to the near side. He's got it. Out of bounds is Dupuy, who's converted for the third time this half for a first down. Forced up by DiCaprio, and he's marked off at the 41-yard line. And for Garneau, with 11:11 left in this quarter, they get a fresh set of downs with 11:08 left in this ball game. Frenette is now the second receiver to the left. Dupuy the second receiver to the right. Gamache firing left, deep far side, incomplete. Intended target was Philippe Rachard. In on the coverage was Ludovic Florent. And it'll be a second and 10 coming up from the 41 with 10:47 left in this ball game. And now for Garneau, they're starting to open up the playbook and look down the menu of options in the menu that they're looking at. And they're passing the ball a lot more than they did in the first half. Gamache now trying to find the right key. Can he unlock this Vanier defense with the right play call? Screen. And that was diagnosed and snuffed out by Vanier's own number 29 in Poulard, intended for LaFontaine, who is asking the referee, was he hooked on that play? Because he couldn't get away from the coverage of Poulard. And with 10:25 left here, becomes a 3rd and 10 and a 10-2 lead for Vanier. And I beg your pardon, it's a second down and 10. So they redo the down. And this will be a redo here. Or now they'll reverse again. because initially it was going to be third down and not second down. And this should be a third down. And there's a lot of confusion right now in the congregation of the referees who are conversing about what the down is. And it'll be third down. So they corrected the mistake. So a third and 10 for Garneau from the 41-yard line. Gamache has got three to his left, two to the right. Motion out to the left side of the formation. Gamache looking towards that side. Firing away, overthrowing. Almost picked off. Intended for Marcotte. And right there was Florent. Along with Cucci. And they couldn't get that ball back in favor of Vanney. So it'll be a punt coming up here for the Elan with 10:09 left in this quarter of play. And Tremblay, we at the midfield stripe just below the logo. And set the return. The punt will be Leba, who's on the near side 10. And this will go out of play. And this might be a generous start of field position for Vanier as they'll get the ball at the 25-yard line. So 9:59 left here. And for Coach Joe Kolzak, does he have the drive here to get this team their chance to kill off the seconds and get himself another score, which would make it a two-score game up by 8. Jordan El Rimawi trying to find the end zone. He's produced 3 points so far for this Cheetah offense. 4 to the right. Latondres is the fourth receiver. Ball is the third receiver on that formation. Here's a handoff to the left side. Flagging the play, and counter is brought down by Johnson at the line of scrimmage. Flag in the backfield, and this will go against Vanier. And this is not what Vanier wants to do as they are veering in reverse towards their goalpost. Holding against Cheetahs, first and 20. And because of that, this will be a first and 20 from the 15. 9:35 left in this football game. El Rimawi, swing pass right. Bile, far side, 10. And he's brought down by Senez. And he's also brought down by Goujon Belanger. And with 9:20 left in this game, it remains a second down and extremely long with 9:13 rolling. And Vanney keeping it rather vanilla. Do not want to put the young quarterback El Rimawi in a position of vulnerability. Handoff, calendar. Evades one to the 15. And he's brought down just shy of the 18-yard line. And he was knocked over by Shatila. With 8:50 left here, third down coming up here for the Cavaliers, for the Cheetahs, that is, with 3:25 left in this ballgame. Clock is rolling. Could they get a few more yards to work with to give themselves an extension of field spacing? Bile is the third receiver to the left. Another handoff to the left. Calendar is going to be brought down, flagging the play. 8:18 left, and this will go against Vanier, and they probably will decline it and force a punt. Or will they push him back? Garneau might be playing the field position here and forcing Vanier to go back even further with 8:18 left. So they are going to move them back. And literally be at the borderline of the end zone of the Vanier side of the football field. And now a test of fiber for this Cheetah offense here. Can they get a few more yards to work with and make this a much easier punt if they cannot convert for the first down? El Rimawi over the middle. Latondres on the reception. Tackle at the 21. Brought down by number 21 and Rancor. And this will be a fourth down for the Cheetahs. Punt coming up here with 8:12 left in this ball game. And Vanier will look to their defense to hold serve again and keep Garneau at bay. Grenier will be the one who will put the ball away. And La Rochelle, along with Dupuis, all will be the returners. They'll be marked off at the 45-yard line, respectively. Clock is underway. Grenier, almost blocked, but a beautiful punt by him. Takes a hop in favor of Vanier, that is. And now it is going to be brought into the 48-yard line, flagging the play. La Rochelle, the returner. And we'll see who this will be against. And from the looks of it, it is going against Garneau. So they'll move him back south of 8 left in this ball game. So what would have been great field position on the geography map of where they were located, they'll be moving back a few more yards. Could they find some dare in this offense here for Garneau? They've had the marauding ability at times here, but they've had no end product of points. Again, the 2 points have come off of the Vanier conceding the safety. All 12 points have been from Vanier. But right now, all Garneau needs is 8 points to tie this game up with 7:50 left in this ballgame. Gamache has got 3 to his right. Here's a handoff. And a spin. The pirouette does not work for LaFontaine as he is brought down rather instantly by Niadaro. And it will be a second and long coming up for the Garneau offense. Working with a little bit more urgency than before. Gamache blitz on the near side. Firing. Blocked. Deflected by Niandaro again as he's wrecked 2 plays in a row, 3rd and 13. That ball was intended for 81 and Mathis Jeté. And now a 3rd and 13 with the 7:13 left in this ball game. Gamache. He's got Dupuis, who's been his first down maker. He's the second receiver to the left. Could he come up with his 4th converted first down of the day? Gamache looking. Left side. Bernier. Incomplete. Second drop in this quarter. And unfortunately for the young Adam Bernier, it has not been his day so far catching the football. And be a punt coming up here for the Elan with 6:53 left in this ball game. So Garneau will punt the ball away. And Leba will be the one who will return it. He is going to be parked off at his 30. Tremblay will get it. And he will fire one away. Leba at his own 28, far side. Flagging the play, 40. This will be brought back, and he's brought down 2 flags on the play, but this will be probably against Vanier on a legal block. And Vanier will be going in reverse towards the 26, 27-yard line. We'll see where. And this is going to go even further than expected. This is going to go towards the 18-yard line. This has been the neck of the woods here for both teams, starting position-wise. Vanier needs to get a couple of first downs, really put the squeeze on this game. Blitz from the far side. Over the middle, almost picked off. Flagging the play, Latendresse in on the coverage. Boiteau-Paré along with Senez And I thought Andres was the one who was going to come up with the catch, perhaps. But this might be a penalty going against Garneau. And Vanny might have their get-out-of-jail card applied in this situation. They will indeed. So they'll get a first down from the 30 with 6:17 left here. So they'll get a pass interference call against FX Garneau, against Garneau, that is. This game's been lacking the scoreboard lining up here, and now head off the counter. And he will grind up ahead, brought down by Rancor for a 1 or 2 yard gain with 6 to go in this ball game. Clock is rolling, second down and about 8.5 coming up here. .546 left in this ball game. Lat Andres, second receiver on the left. Bile is the third receiver on the right. 7 in the box for Garneau. El Rimawal looking towards the right through the hands of Bile. Had too much spice in that pass with 5:30 left here. 38 coming up for the Cheetahs. And Vanier. 5:30 seems like an eternity for them, for Garneau. 5:30 seems like it's too short of a time frame left in this ball game. 3rd and 8, 5:20 left in this football game. El Rimawal rolling to his right, protection there, pointing deep. Bile intercepted by Garneau. Gujon Belanger comes up with a big INT and gives a lifeline to Garneau. His second interception of the day, 5:09 left in this ball game. And a chance now for Garneau. And Gujon Belanger is making a name for himself with a cracking effort today. And a 10-2 lead, 5:09 left in this game. Late to the party is one of the Garneau players. And can they cash in on this ticket here late in this ball game? Gamache has not found any rhythm yet with anyone but Dupuy. Going to the left side. And here's Dupuy. Tough hands, and he'll have enough for a first down. That's been his go-to maker right now. And he has come up with another first down, his 4th of the day. And they'll have to hold off a second here to get the sticks properly adjusted with the ball at the 51-yard line. 1st and 10 from the 51, Vanier. Gamache, hitch pass left, Dupuy. And he will be taken out by DiCaprio, by Poulard. You can name whoever you want from that Vanny defense that came up with a tackle with 4:30 left in this ball game. Could Gamache find the arts and crafts on this drive? Trips right for Gamache. Frenette is the third receiver on that side of the formation. 2nd and 9. Looking towards the middle, open! 30, 25, 20, will not be caught. Touchdown, Vanier. Touchdown, Garneau. Mathis Jeté, 51-yard catch and run. And a 10-8 lead, pending the 2-point cover, perhaps, for Garneau. And Mathis Jeté with a massive moment in this game, with a starburst finish. And now, a chance. To tie it up at 10. The key moment now is on this play. 10-8 lead for Vanny over Garneau. Gamache in the pistol. La Rochelle in the backfield. 3 to his right, 2 to the left. Eyeball to eyeball. Who can come with a big play now? A test of nerve. Gamache looking to the left. Incomplete. No flag. Intended for Lemoyne. And it remains a 10-8 lead. Vanny holding on with 3:55 left. Plenty of time left in this ballgame as Mathis Jeté on a 51-yard touchdown catch and run makes it a 10-8 lead with 3:55 left. Garneau delivering a blow to the jaw of Vanier. Vanier now a little bit wobbly in the knees, but the question now comes up, could Vanier come up with points themselves? They are up by two, clinging on to this fight. Round number 12 upon us here. It's been body blow after body blow. But could Vanny finally come up with a knockout punch with 3:55 left in this football game? And just don't forget, Garneau did go with a trick play on special teams. Could they perhaps go for an onside kick now to surprise Vanier? It'll be Damaris who will be the one who will kick it off. He'll park it on the left hash mark on the far side. Vanier is prepping for what could be a pooch kick. The wind is picking up now, going left to right on your screen. Damaris will have an overload towards his left, but he will kick it away to the far side, return from the 10, up to the 15. And the coverage team coming up massive for Garneau. And Vanier will be starting deep, deep in their territory. And Lazard on the return didn't get much. And with 3:48 left here, again, this clock seems like an eternity for Vanier. And momentum might be swinging back to the team in white and Kelly Green. El Rimawi. Pressure makes diamonds. Could he become a diamond in the rough in this game here for Vanier? Handoff, Callender left side. Callender has not been able to get going since the first quarter. Brought down by Bolio Dallard. The D lineman coming up with a tackle on that play. Clock is still going. And Dallard had four tackles last week and a sack and two TFLs. And this will be 3:15 left here, second and 11. A loss of one from the 18. El Rimawi. Going to the left. Latondres, too much on that. It stops clock, south of three. Third down coming up here from the 19. 3-minute warning called. And now this is where we find out who can come up with the victory in this ball game. Ball at the 18-yard line. 2:59 left in this football game. And you feel the tension here being palpable in this matchup. It's been a full-blooded affair. A masterclass on defense by both teams. And the passage of the play has not been as prominent as it was for Garneau last Saturday against St. Jean. For Vanier, it looked like they were going to have memories evoked of their free-flowing offense on the first drive of the game when Sulakis got that opening touchdown pass. But points have been at high currency as we speak here. And right now for Vanier, the currency is to get a first down and kill off more seconds. Their defense has been playing well. Could he give them a respite here with 2:59 left in this football game? ...10-8 lead for the Cheetahs over the Elan of Garneau. El Rimawi came in for Sulakis. For Sulakis late in the first half. Sulakis took a sack, and it's been El Rimawi who's been at quarterback. third and 10. Middle. Caught. First down and more. Pressure makes diamonds. And Bile is a gem among the crown jewels on that play. 2:51 left in this football game. A gain of 25. Now at the 40. And a deep breath taken by the Vanier bench. Clock is rolling. Bile was acrobatic and emphatic on that play. Elmi Moui. Handoff. Calendar. Gets a couple yards on that play. 2:30 left in this ball game. Ball now at the 41-yard line. And now moved up to the 42. So 41 and three quarters here. Tension on both sides of the benches here. If you have no nails as a fan of one of these teams here, this game is going to come down to what could be the final play. 2:14 left. Blitz from both sides. Deflected. Incomplete. Bile was the hot route. And right there was Demers in on the coverage. And it appears that Charon got his telescopic arm up there to deflect that ball. Third and eight. Another money down play for the Cheetahs. Latendresse is on the left. Charles is on the left. Screen. It's messed up. It's broken up. And this goes out of bounds. And Garneau complaining about the penalty as Shatila thought he was denied by Dwayne Charles to go for the ball, but that ball was well out of bounds. And a fourth down coming up here with 2:02 left. So Vanier's offense will have to come off the field, but they did get a critical third down conversion that killed off some more seconds. And now all eyes will be on the Garneau's offense, on if they can get themselves the potential game-winning points via field goal or touchdown. Grenier will put the ball away. Two returners left. It'll be Dupuis along with La Rochelle. La Rochelle on the near side, Dupuis on the far side. Grenier's kick will go to La Rochelle, near side 32. Surveys, 45. Out of bounds, flagging the play as La Rochelle ended up in the first row of the bleachers. Flagging the play on the near side. And La Rochelle is slow to get up. He is hurt, and that is not good news for Garneau. So if they lose one of their big hitters on offense, they might put the onus on Dupuis, on LaFontaine, and others. So La Rochelle is hurt right now, being looked at by the training staff. And it might have been his left side, and they're looking at the left foot. Mustard is a form of source of hydration, actually. Mustard is a form of hydration out there for those who are watching right now, as he did have his mustard to look at. So La Rochelle having some mustard to hydrate his body. 1:51 left here in this ballgame. That ball will move back over to the 37-yard line. First and 10 for Garneau from the 37-yard line. Gamache has got three to the left, two to the near side right. Dupuis, the second receiver on that right side. He's been the money man so far for the Elan. Going to the wide side. Open, that's caught. Turning and brought down is Jeté, the touchdown maker, as right there is Florent, who did not give any yak on that play with 1:44 left in this ballgame. Trips right again. Going to the left, Dupuis. His fifth catch of the day, and another first down maker for him. 1:35 left here. First down And now the ball will be at the 54-yard line of the Garneau side of the field. They in Garneau would probably require another 25 more yards to get in field goal range. 95 seconds left in this game. Plenty of time to go. Plenty of time in jeopardy to go. Handoff middle. LaFontaine will back his way into the 50 of Vanier with 1:28 left in this football game. And they're going to go with no huddle, trying to keep Vanier on their heels. And again, you have to wonder for Vanier's battery power right now, if they're at their lowest of lows in energy consumption. Blitz, stepping up, middle, caught, first down, and more. Mathis Jette, same play, brought down by Cucci, and now they're at the 35-yard line with 1:17 left. Vanier in the corner, taking a flurry of punches from Garneau. 1:17 left to go. Gamache looking towards the right. Hitch incomplete. Marcotte, the intended receiver. Florent, the coverage man. 1:10 left. And what can they come up here in the bag of tricks from the Garneau offense? Vanny has to get it right on this defensive play. 1:10 left. Second and 10 from the 35-yard line. They're showing blitz. They come on the blitz. Pressure middle. Caught. And right there is Jolie in on the tackle. As Jette got about five on that play with 1:03 left. He's had some big catches in the last 5 minutes of this ball game. Jolie now has three to his right. Looking, hitch left. Caught by Dupuy, out of bounds. Stopping the clock with 54 seconds left. Dupuy forced out by Millien. And it'll be third down and four coming up for the Elan. From the 28-yard line. They're in field goal range. And they'll bring on the field goal kicking team in Demers now in case there is a botch. Now it's a fourth down officially now. So this is it here. Fourth down. Timeout called by Vanier. Fourth down from the 28-yard line. Wind is going north to south. And for Vanier, the hard work that they built into this game here, up by eight for the entire game, they've led from tape to tape so far. It'll be a sucker punch ending if Garneau gets this field goal to go through, if Garneau could pull off the smash and grab here. This would be the great escape for Garneau. They've been down for the entire game. As Kolzak comes out to give his team the last second instructions on this fourth down, and a field goal for Demers. This will be from 28 yards out. Demers will be at his 35 left hash mark. Wind has calmed down. The holder will be Jette, the touchdown maker for Garneau. 54 seconds left. A test of fiber. Hold, kick. Operation is good. 11-10 lead for Garneau with 49.4 left. And for Vanier, they are down to their last round. And for Garneau, they are on cloud nine in this utopian world of theirs. They were down for the entire game and now have their first lead with 49.4 left in this football game. Could they pull off the great escape here with 49.4 left? And is now on this Vandy offense, El Rima Wee, will have to engineer and author a possession to get themselves in field goal range. They have the kicking ability to do so with Laurent Gagné. Could they get this within the 30 to 40 yard range of a field goal attempt for Vanier? And Vanier will opt for the ball at the 35 yard line. 49.4 left in this ball game. All eyes on Jordan El Rimawa. He has an overload of four on the right. Dwayne Charles is the receiver occupying the left. Empty backfield. Rolling pressure. Taking off El Rimaway to the 40. And he's brought down by Gujian Belanger with 40.1 left here. Second down coming up for the Cheetahs. Ball at the 40 and a half yard line. 40 seconds left, second and five. They need to get another 35 yards at least for field goal range. Stepping up, pressure incomplete, picked off. Picked off by Shatila, and that might do it. Flagging the play as Garneau will pull the smash and grab with 30.7 left in this football game. And heartbreak for Vanier. And for Garneau, it will be a sweet bus ride back to Quebec City with win number two, 30 seconds away. And for the Vanier staff and for the players, it'll be a long week as they prepare for their next game. And they'll be away in Lennoxville. Garneau will be home to Limoilou next week. And Garneau is sending a warning shot to the Division I big hitters that they are here. And a penalty was called as well. And Limoilou and Garneau will have better field position. First and 10. And now it's a formality of the kneel down, the victory formation, the best formation in football for the winning side. Gamache was the third string quarterback. He came in the second half. And for Mathis Jeté, he got the touchdown. And the game-winning field goal came off the foot of Maxence Demers. And for Vanier, this will be a tough loss for this young team trying to learn and grow. They lost Koulakis in the first half to an injury and gave it their best shot. But unfortunately for them, Garneau came up with a knockout punch. Garneau will go 2-0. Vanier will drop to 0-2. And they win for the second consecutive year in St. Laurent over the Cheetahs. Final score, Garneau 11, Vanier 10. A massive game for Garneau in the second half. Mathis Jeté with a clutch touchdown catch. And for Jonathan Dupuis, he had multiple first down conversions on third down. And Vanier will now go back to the whiteboard, reconfigure and reconsider what they have to do to get win number one as they hit on the road for the next 2 weeks. And for Garneau, it'll be a bus ride that they will enjoy going back to Quebec City. That will do it from here. Vanier come up short, losing 11-10 to Garneau. Garneau now 2-0, Vanier 0-2. We'll see you in a few weeks from now. Bye for now.
The dogs have gone, 70 dogs have gone.